Alright, so should you be paying taxes for your Shopify dropshipping business? If it was up to me, absolutely not. What's going on, everybody? Your boy Juan Valdez back with another video. And today I'm going to be going over taxes and a little bit of business structure and more of the legal aspect of your Shopify dropshipping business. Now, for those of you guys that are brand new to my channel, welcome on over. This is to the VFAM. The VFAM is a family of individuals that are striving to do a lot more than what society has out for us to do. And one of those things that for sure I didn't learn in school, I'm not sure about you guys, is taxes and the proper business structures to have in a place and why they're important. So I figured, why not take a few minutes to kind of make this video for you guys and kind of share my experience with both taxes and business structures, and hopefully you guys can pick up a thing or two. So if you guys want to see a lot more videos or any more videos about, you know, taxes or business structure or anything else that involves like the legal aspect of running a Shopify dropshipping business, make sure you drop a like on this video. And if you have any questions along the way about anything that I go over, drop them in the comments below. I'll make sure to get back to you guys. And if you haven't already, make sure you join the VFAM, smash that subscribe button. I would say for anyone that's just getting started, at first, you don't have to worry about it as much, right? Your main focus at first, of course, is learning how the whole business works, learning about, of course, how to set up a store that actually converts, how to pick a niche, how to find hot products, how to, you know, market and run ads, and a whole lot more. So all those things obviously are, you know, take up a good amount of time and work. So obviously you want to have your main focus on that. So at first, you know, you don't really have to focus on taxes. I didn't start really working on taxes myself or keeping track of everything, you know, as far as like expenses, profit, all that stuff, probably until I was making like consistently over $1,000 a day. Because obviously at that time, at that point, once you're making $1,000 a day, it can start adding up. And once tax season comes around, if you don't have the numbers in place, then it can get a lot more difficult to, you know, kind of keep track of everything and, you know, kind of go through your business. So you want to make sure that, you know, after you start generating roughly around like $1,000 in sales a day, then you start, you know, obviously taking care of, you know, taxes, keeping track of, you know, business expenses, profit, all that stuff, because it will be important later on once tax season does come around. Just to give you guys some preface, I am not an accountant. When I first got started, I didn't have an accountant either. I kind of just track things like with an Excel sheet. But after I got to that point where I was doing over $1,000 a day consistently, I then hired a CPA, a full-time accountant, which pretty much helps me out with everything that involves, you know, with taxes and how I should do things the right way and a whole lot more. So a lot of the things I'll be sharing with you guys, I'm not just coming up with, I'm literally just taking the things that I learned from him and sharing with you guys. So now, one of the things you guys want to do for sure, apart from just running a Shopify dropshipping business, is learn about, you know, taxes, tax brackets, how it really works, depending on, you know, what state you live in and all that stuff. But also learn about business structures, right? Like what's an LLC, what's an S corp, you know, what's a C corp, all the different business structures, because both of those are super important, right? You know, obviously this main video is going to be mainly about taxes, but depending on what kind of business structure you have, sometimes does determine, like, you know, different factors about how much taxes you pay. For me personally, when it comes to the sales that I was tracking, obviously when it came down to taxes, I actually was not charging any taxes for any of the sales that I was making in my Shopify dropshipping business. And one of the reasons as to why I didn't, you know, charge for taxes was, I know for a fact that when I'm buying something online, for me personally, there's two things I kind of don't like paying for. I don't like paying for shipping, and I don't like paying for taxes. Try to remove anything that can potentially turn the customer off from buying from you, right? Me personally, having a customer not pay for shipping or taxes, I'm not saying that you guys should charge the same for your products and not charge for shipping or taxes. What I'm saying is, rather than showing the customer that they're actually paying for taxes or showing them that they're paying for the shipping, you can just increase the price of your product by whatever both of those kind of come out to you. One of the things I would do is I would just increase, you know, an extra few dollars in my profit margins for every single product. And that makes it a lot easier because, again, customers are coming in, they're seeing that they don't have to pay for shipping and there's no taxes. Like, now they're getting a really good deal. You know, once you start actually tracking your taxes, right? Because again, what I would recommend is, well, after you get to this point where you're making consistent sales and not charging for shipping and taxes, you then obviously want to go see a CPA, a certified personal accountant, because they're going to show you all the ins and outs and all different ways that you can go about taxes. You want to know about taxes because learning about taxes and business structures leads to tons of benefits, right? And for those of you guys that are thinking like, oh, hiring an accountant might be super expensive, well, believe it or not, the money that you end up paying for a certified personal accountant or CPA is usually a lot less than the money that they end up saving you. If they're gonna save you money, and it's gonna be a lot more than you would have saved if you didn't have an accountant, which means more money in your pocket, why wouldn't you do it? You know, for me, I'm always about, you know, smart decisions. So our accountant, I don't know, we pay him like a monthly fee. I think it's like $200 to $300 a month that I pay him. And he literally helps me save a lot more than I was saving before when I had no accountant. So why wouldn't I pay him the $300? He's literally putting more money back into my pocket. So I'd recommend for those of you guys, once you get to like that $1,000 a day mark, that's when I recommend to do it. And the reason why I would recommend to you for you to do it at that point is because usually accountants aren't too cheap. So obviously, I mean, you wouldn't want a really cheap accountant. You want to get a quality, somebody that's good at what they do and a whole lot more, because if you don't get a really good accountant, they're not going to be able to show you all the possible ways that you can reduce, of course, your business expenses and how you can pay less taxes. So that's one of the biggest things I learned from some of my mentors, is that they always have accountants on board and lawyers as well. I would recommend for you guys to put together an Excel sheet tracking everything, right? Because if you start getting used to doing that early on when you don't have as many sales, later on it'll get a lot easier, because once you set up an Excel sheet where you can track everything, you can later on hire an assistant to help you fill it out and you don't have to do it yourself. I hope you guys got value from this video. If you did, of course, make sure you drop a like on it. If you have any questions about anything I went over, drop them in the comments below. And of course, if you haven't already, make sure you join the V fam, smash that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.